Hello everyone, welcome to Easy Engineering Classes. We are continuing with the preparation series of various computer science competitive exams, and in this series we solve previous year questions from GATE computer science paper, UGC NET paper or bank IT officer exam. So in today's lecture we'll start with a question from operating system subject, and this question appeared in GATE 2015 paper. So the question is, consider a uniprocessor system executing three tasks T1, T2, T3, each of which is composed of an infinite sequence of jobs which arrive periodically at intervals of 3, 7 and 20 milliseconds respectively. The priority of each task is the inverse of its period, and the available tasks are scheduled in order of priority, with the highest priority task scheduled first. So each instance of T1, T2, T3 requires an execution time of 1, 2 and 4 milliseconds respectively. Given that all the tasks initially arrive at the beginning of first millisecond and task preemptions are allowed, the first instance of T3 completes its execution at the end of dash millisecond. So it's a numerical type of question in which you have to calculate, perform all those operations that you have given in the question and then fill in the blank. Okay. So important things to note in this question are that there are three tasks which will keep on arriving at particular intervals. Okay. So they are not always available. That means, if I write down T1, T2 and T3, so the first instance of all these three is available at 1 millisecond, okay? But after 1 millisecond, they arrive at different intervals, okay? So the T1 task arrives after 3 milliseconds, so 1 plus 3, 4 milliseconds, the next instance of T1 will arrive at 4 milliseconds. Then T2 arrives after 7 milliseconds. So after 1 millisecond, T2, the second instance of T2 would arrive at 8 milliseconds, and T3 will arrive at 20 milliseconds plus 1 millisecond. That means the second instance would arrive 20 milliseconds later than the first instance, okay, and so this will arrive at 21 milliseconds. Okay, now continuing in this manner, the third instance of T1, T2, T3 would arrive at 4 plus 3, that means 7 milliseconds, then 8 plus 7, which is equal to 15 milliseconds, then T3 would arrive at 21 plus 20, which is 41 millisecond. Okay, and if you go on and continue in this manner, the fourth instance of T1 arrives at 10 millisecond. Then here it arrives at 15 plus 7, which is 22 millisecond, and 41 plus 20, again 61 millisecond, and so on. Okay, so we have to find out that at what time the first instance of T3 completes. Now you are given that the priority of these three processes is different. Okay, so all of them are not of the same priority, since it is given that the priority is inversely proportional to the period. This is the period. Period means that at what or after what interval of time these jobs are repeating or the instances appear. So lowest priority, lowest period is of T1. So T1 would have the highest priority. Okay. So let me write down here in terms of priority. T1 would have the highest priority because it has the lowest period. Then the second highest priority will be of T2, and then T3 would have the lowest priority because it has the maximum period. Okay. Now, what does this mean? That if we have to preempt a particular process, it will be preempted in case a higher priority process arrives. Now, another thing that is specified to you in this question is the execution time. What does that say? That T1 takes 1 millisecond to complete, but T2 and T3 take more milliseconds, more amount of time to complete. And how much is that time? Let's see. T2 takes 2 milliseconds to complete, and T3 takes 4 milliseconds to complete. Alright, so using all this information, we'll find out how much time, or at the end of what time, T3's first instance gets completed. Okay, now starting with the 0th time, since 0 to 1, no process is available. All the processes, or the first instances of all these three processes, become available at time instance 1. So at 0 to 1, nothing is available. At time 1, all of T1, T2 and T3 are available. That means the first instance of each of T1, T2 and T3 is available, but since T1 has the highest priority, we'll take up T1 and execute it. Now, how much time does one instance of T1 require to complete? It only requires 1 millisecond. So at 2 millisecond, it is completed. Now at 2 millisecond, we have how many processes do we have? We have process T2 and we have task T3. Okay, so T2 has higher priority. So we'll schedule T2 here, the first instance of T2 here. And since T2 requires 2 milliseconds to complete, therefore 2 to 3 and another millisecond. So the first instance of T2 would be completed by 4 milliseconds. Now what happens at 4 milliseconds? At this point of time, the first instance of T3 is available, as well as the second instance of T1 is available. Alright, see, the second instance of T1 arrives at 4 milliseconds. But since T1 has the higher priority than T3, therefore we'll schedule T1 now. So we schedule T1. The second instance of T1 again completes in 1 millisecond. That means at 5 millisecond it has completed. Now at 5 millisecond, what do we have? Which tasks do we have? T1 has arrived at 4 and now it is finished by 5 millisecond. The second instance of T2 is not yet present. It will come at 8 millisecond, but we still have one instance of T3, which is the first instance of T3 in fact. So we start the first instance of T3 and schedule it 1 millisecond at a time. At 6 millisecond, no other process of higher priority is available, so we keep on executing T3. At 7 millisecond, we again see that the third instance of T1 has arrived. Now T3 will again be preempted and T1 would be scheduled. And T1 takes 1 millisecond to complete, so it will complete in this time. So here T1 required 1 millisecond, it completed. T2, the first instance of T2. Required 2 milliseconds, so it also completed. The second instance of T1 required a single millisecond, this is also complete. But T3 takes 4 milliseconds to complete and it has only executed till 2 milliseconds. So there are remaining 2 milliseconds of the first instance of T3. So let's continue and see at what time T3 would be complete. Now at 8 milliseconds, we see that the second instance of T2 also arrives. Okay, so since T2, the priority of T2 is higher than the priority of the remaining portion of T3, therefore we schedule T2, and we know that T2 has to complete in 2 milliseconds, or it takes 2 milliseconds to complete. Therefore we'll keep on executing T2 to its entirety, because there is no higher priority process, that is, there is no higher priority task present right now. So T2 executes for 2 milliseconds till time period 10. Okay, now what happens at time period 10, T2 is complete and T3 tries to take the execution, but again the fourth instance of T1 arrives at this point. Okay, at this point we have T1 as well as the remaining portion of the first instance of T3. Okay, so since T1 has higher priority, so we'll schedule T1 here. T1 only requires a single millisecond to complete, so it will complete by 11 milliseconds. Now at 11 milliseconds, what processes do we have? Only the remaining 2 milliseconds of T3 are there, because we neither have any instance of T2. T2 would now next arrive at 15 and T1 would next arrive at 13. Okay, so we can execute the remaining 2 seconds of T3 till 13. So T3 completes at 13. Therefore, what would be the answer in this case? The first instance of T3 completes its execution at the end of 12 milliseconds, because 12 milliseconds started at this point and 12 milliseconds ended at this point. Therefore, T3 completed its execution at 12 milliseconds. I would request the students to be very careful in such questions, because sometimes what happens that they correctly calculate this answer but still write the answer as 13. So please read the question very carefully. It's asking at the end of dash millisecond. Therefore, the answer would be 12. So that's all for today's lecture. If you understood this video, please mention in the comment section below. Like this video and share it with your friends. And let us know if you require more such tutorials in our preparation series. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned. Good luck.